Hi guys, welcome to Fieldey TV. I'm Fieldey, I'm a pro muralist and I run an online art school, Fieldey's Art Academy. So I started out my art career painting surfboards and canvases and made the transition to painting walls over 9 years ago now. Figuring out how to transfer my art skills and styles to such a big canvas was a huge learning curve. So I'm here to give you my top 10 things that you probably don't know about painting murals until you've done some. Before we crack on with number one, I just wanted to let you know that in my academy, I have my ultimate mural painting guide. So this is a course which truly is the ultimate guide to painting murals. If you're thinking about painting murals, then click on the link, I think it's on that side, to check it out. And I'm gonna walk you through the entire mural process from start to finish. Right. Let's jump into the number one first thing that you really need to know about painting murals, and that is wall preparation is not optional. So 80% of all mural paint failure can be related directly back to bad surface preparation. So, you know, if you want your paint to last on the wall for a really long time, then you need to make sure that you've spent some time prepping the wall correctly before you start. What you need to do is, first off, clean the wall. So a mild soap solution to get rid of the dirt and any other impurities that will show up in your paint. Then you're gonna repair any of the holes and cracks in the wall, and you're gonna use a scraper to remove peeling paint. If the wall has already been painted using oil-based or a high gloss paint, then you're gonna need to apply a coat of primer before you paint it. If you're painting on bare metal, you're gonna have to apply a specialty metal primer before you paint as well. Spending time on prepping your wall correctly will definitely give you the best possible finished result. Think of it kind of like gessoing a canvas to prepare it for painting. Number two, don't use paint that's designed for indoor use outside. You can't use interior paint on an outside wall and expect it to last. And this is because exterior paints have specialist additives added to them to withstand the elements. This goes the same for those little like test pot color paints. Don't use them outside either. They're terrible for outside murals. Number three, some paint colors will fade. So no matter how good the quality of the paint is that you're using, if it's on an outside wall, it's going to eventually fade. And that goes even if the paint manufacturer has a guarantee. Red is gonna fade the fastest, but orange and yellows will fade quick as well. Number four, reduce the detail. So when I first started out painting murals, walls would take me at least twice as long as they do now because I was obsessed with getting every single tiny little detail on the wall, much as I would on a smaller canvas or a surfboard. Try not to do this. It's a massive waste of your time. Walls are designed to be viewed from, you know, much further away than a canvas or a picture. So if you're in doubt about whether to add more detail or to go nuts on it, just step back to the viewing distance to view your wall and then make a decision at that distance whether you think it needs more detail or not. Five, painting walls and murals is manual labor. So painting murals and walls may look like a lot of fun, and it is pretty fun, but it's also really hard work. That first day of painting is typically the hardest, man. That's gonna smash you. So you're gonna be on your feet for most of the day, climbing ladders and moving them around, using rollers and lifting heavy crates of paint. So after that, you know, your feet are probably gonna hurt, your back's gonna ache, and you may have blisters on your fingers if you've been doing a lot of rollering. Number six, if you're creating a geometric mural with tape, don't be cheap. Use the best quality tape you can afford. Cheap tape will give you a rubbish, kind of fuzzy edged result, and it can even peel off the paint layers beneath, so making you a huge amount of extra trouble and a lot of extra work. Instead of using cheap masking tape, use washi tape or 14 days painter's tape. Seven, you don't need to clear coat a mural. That is, unless you need an anti-graffiti coating. So house paints and aerosol paint colors do not need a clear coat to protect them. They're already waterproof and hard wearing. The only reason you do need to clear coat a mural is to protect it from tagging or smog or pollution. If you're gonna apply an anti-graffiti coating, that then brings me to number eight. there are different types of anti-graffiti coatings. So anti-graffiti coatings can be roughly split into three main categories. That is sacrificial, semi-sacrificial, and non-sacrificial. So sacrificial coatings are a non-permanent protection against graffiti that will not harm your artwork. If it needs to be cleaned, the coating will be washed away along with the graffiti, leaving your artwork intact. There are also semi-sacrificial types of coatings that rely on kind of like multiple thin applications of coating, so that if one coat needs to be removed, there's going to be more there to act as a barrier underneath. So if you get to the end of all the coatings, you have to then reapply them all again. The strongest and most hard wearing are the non-sacrificial products. So these are permanent, heavy duty coatings that's going to create a strong bond over your artwork, allowing graffiti and grime to be removed multiple times. So kind of think of something like a car coating there. Number nine, if you're painting on the street, random people are going to watch you work. They will also have opinions, sometimes very strong opinions, about what you're doing. I've had a few instances where people have wanted to give me their 2 cents worth, or, you know, tell me that a half finished mural is ugly. It's all part of the joy of working out in the public. The very last one, number 10, is you need to know at least 3 methods for getting your concept lines onto the wall. Scaling your concept onto the wall is sometimes the most stressful step, and it's really important that you get it right. I've turned up at a wall at night intending to use a projector to scale up the concept, only to find out that there's like a street light that interferes with the projector lamp, or find out that the projector can't get far enough back from the wall to project the image up correctly. This sort of thing happens all the time, so it's a great idea to know or be comfortable with at least 3 of these following methods so that you have a backup if your first method doesn't work for any reason. So you can use a projector, you can grid the artwork, you can use the scribble grid method, or freehand drawing as well, obviously. If you want to see how any of these methods are done, then please check out my mini module, Scaling Your Concept Onto the Wall, and I'll show you how they're done and give you the pros and cons for each method. I hope these 10 tips have helped you get through the you can't know what you don't know stage of starting out with murals, and it's given you some things to be aware of and increased your chances for success. So if you want to know my full, completely foolproof mural painting process, then again, please check out my ultimate mural guide. Thanks so much for watching. Please subscribe, you know, hit share, give me a thumbs up. And also, can you let me know if you have any other tips that you think would be useful for beginners to know?